guys, what's up? In my earlier video, I told you guys that I will explain in my next video how to draw a check. In this video, we are going to cover the concept of checks by covering golden rule of accounting in banking, cross check and uncross check, transferring funds through same bank, transferring funds through different bank, precautions and parameters to fill. So let's get started. As I mentioned in my earlier video, the golden rule of accounting is applied in every transaction of banking, and hence two entries come every time we do a bank transaction. When you remove cash from your account, debit your savings bank account, credit cash account of the bank. When you deposit cash in your bank account, debit cash account of the bank, credit your savings bank account. When you transfer funds from your account to your friend's account in the same bank, debit your savings bank account and credit to your friend's savings bank account. When you transfer funds from your account through NEFT to your friend's account at another bank, debit your savings bank account. Credit means send funds online through your friend's account of another bank. Again, I'm repeating here. Credit means deposit and debit means payment / withdrawal. Cross-check and uncross-check. Further, before we move ahead, I will give you some important details of cross-check and uncross-check. Whenever you give a check debit authority to your banker, you give certain instructions to your banker through check. Major of such instructions is cross-check and uncross-check. As I mentioned in my earlier video, cross-check means funds need to be routed through accounts, and uncross-check means cash withdrawal from the counter, or uncross check cannot be transferred through bank accounts, which can be paid over the counter. In short, when you wish to remove cash from your account, you need to give your banker an uncross check. And when you wish to transfer the funds by debiting your account and crediting it to your friend's account, you need to give a cross check. When you wish to transfer funds to your friend's account having account in the same bank. Suppose you wish to give money to your friend through check. You need to name your friend at the place of pay. However, your banker does not get an idea where your friend is having the account, whether in the same bank or not even what his account number is. Hence, you need to attach a pay-in slip mentioning therein the details of your payee, like the account number, name of the account, bank name, branch name. If your payee has account in the same bank, the banker immediately transfers the funds by debiting your account and crediting to your friend's account as per the details in the pay-in slip. When you wish to transfer funds to your friend's account having account in a different bank, you have two options. Either you can send funds through clearing or NEFT /RTGS. Sending funds through clearing. When you wish to transfer the funds to your friend's account whose account is in a different bank, you mention the name of your friend in the place of payee and attach a pay-in slip wherein your friend's account details like account number, name of the account, bank name, branch name are filled. When your friend is having account in a different bank, your banker cannot credit your friend's account directly and he will send the check to the clearing house, government bodies to take care of the checks of different banks. The clearing house then collect the amount from your account and then send the said amount to your friend's bank who will credit the said amount in your friend's account. This process takes usually a 3-day period. Sending funds through NEFT /RTGS. But nowadays, due to the online transfer of facility through NEFT or RTGS, we can credit the pay's account at a different bank within a few minutes. If you wish to transfer funds to your friend's account through NEFT at a different bank, instead of pay-in slip, you need to give NEFT details /NEFT form to be filled with all the account details of the payee. Your banker then first debits your account and sends the money through NEFT to your friend's account as per the NEFT details mentioned in the NEFT form. I will explain the concept of NEFT / RTGS in my coming videos. Before we discuss the various situations, we need to draw checks. We need to first see the precautions to be followed while handling the check. These are pretty fragile pieces of information. Precautions. Number 1. A check more than 3 months old will be called a stale check, and the bank will not accept such stale checks. Hence, once the date will be written on the check validity will be up to 3 months from the date of the check. 2. Any corrections, overwriting or erasures is not allowed on the check, or such checks usually get returned by the banker with the remark, "Effects not clear." 3. Check that the account has sufficient funds available to pay the check. If there are no funds available in the account, check will be returned with remarks, lack of or insufficient funds. This is also called check bounced, and this may constitute a crime punishable by imprisonment. The beneficiary, payee of the check, can file a case under Section 138 of Negotiable Instrument Act, and under the said section, the punishment would be double the amount of check and imprisonment. 5. Sign the check with the same signature as on the customer account opening form, means as per records available with the bank. If the signature won't match with the bank's records, the check gets returned with remarks, "Signature differs." 6. Do not sign a blank check and give the duly signed blank check. 7. Always tally the amount to be written in words and figures on the check. 8. Ensure that no check is removed from your checkbook without your knowledge. If you find one missing, then report it to your bank immediately to stop payment of said check. How to draw a check? Check only has limited space to be written. Date. The date of a check, where you need to mention the exact date of the check as days, months and years in the numeric form DDMMYYYY. Amount in figures and words. Then you mention the amount in figures and words that you wish to transfer by debiting your account in the relevant spaces, and you need to sign the check above with your name mentioned on the check. These spaces are similar in every situation. Cross check. Again, I'm explaining the important concept of cross and uncross check. When you wish to transfer funds by debiting your account through NEFT or clearing to the payee's account, you need to cross the check at the left corner of the check and need to cancel the word bearer. In short, meaning of cross check is only to be deposited in payee's account and not to be encashed over the counter. Hence, cross check does not pay in cash. It should be deposited through accounts, and without cross check means the check can be encashed over the counter. In my next video, I will explain the various situations where we need to use a check for money management. And that's it guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Do make sure to like, share and subscribe. And I'll see you around.